The Italian Contemporary Film Festival, ICFF, is a 9-day event which aims to celebrate, explore, and experience Italian contemporary cinema. Every year, the ICFF presents collections of feature films, shorts, and documentaries. These can include premiere screenings as well as advanced screenings and independent films. This is the second year that the ICFF has organized the Lavazza Drive-In Film Festival. Featured at this festival are American, British, Korean, Latinx, African, Chinese, French, Jewish, and many more films. This year's festival also features a special Focus Italia series. We are joined today with Cristiano De Florentis, who is the co-founder and artistic director of the ICFF. I want
to break free. Our crazy stay-at-home time is finally over. I want to break free. Head down to the second edition of the Lavazza Drive-In Film Festival at Ontario Place, June 27th to July 17th. Under the stars, sharing emotion, together again. Enjoy an incredible lineup of new films from 16 different countries around the world with a special focus on Italian contemporary cinema from the safety and comfort of your car. Lavazza Drive-In Film Festival at Ontario Place. Tickets starting from $20. Visit icff.ca or call 416-893-3966 to purchase your tickets now. Brought to you by Chin Radio TV and the ICFF.
Thank you for joining us, Cristiano. Can you tell our audience a little bit about the ICFF Lavazza Drive-In Film Festival and what it is?
So it is a film festival in a moment that is difficult because the theaters are closed, and we invented a new way to offer our audience movies. How? With an old model, the drive-in model. So we transformed the idea of a drive-in in a film festival with the glamour part of the film festival. We invented a drive-through red carpet, an interaction with the audience with Zoom, of course with the filmmakers, with the actors, and it's a multicultural film festival. ICFF is the Italian film festival. We decided to reconnect all the communities through cinema and multicultural cinema. Every night is dedicated to a different community, a different country. For example, today is the National Day for France, and we are dedicating today to France. Tomorrow is going to be the turn of Russia, and after again Italy, and again till Saturday we have an incredible lineup of movies.
Why is it important to you to bring Italian films to a Canadian audience?
Well, Italian cinema, first of all, historically is a nice, beautiful kind of cinema. We are masters in that, but it's not just that. With true cinema, we can bring the lifestyle, the values, the culture. It's a medium that is easy to connect to the audience and bring there a lot of other things. So, again, this is a moment in which we share with the Canadian audience Italian films, but more in general, our cultural value, our language, of course. Again, it's not going to be just Italian films. This year, we decided to connect many other communities with these drive-in theaters.
How did the ICFF Lavazza Film Festival begin?
The Lavazza Drive-In Film Festival began everything last year. It was March when the first idea came to me, because everybody were in some way canceling every events, everything was going digital, and we wanted to find a solution to still deliver a film festival in person. And of course, with the fact that we were under the pandemic, so find a new way to stay safe and still enjoy a movie together with other people, sharing emotions together. And the drive-in formula really helped us a lot.
How did you get involved with the ICFF?
ICFF, I founded it 10 years ago. It was a very small group of people that decided to open a film festival, and we love cinema. And we decided to not just watch the movie by ourselves, to decide to share the the movies to other, with other people. And so step by step, this festival that was very, very small became one of the most important festivals of Italian movies around the world.
What has the reception been like for this film festival so far?
An incredible, incredible success because people love to watch movies with other people, sharing emotion together, find a way to get out from homes and stay in a very safe environment. And so for many of these people in the audience, was the first time that they were enjoying something outside after many months of lockdown. So an incredible success, and I'm very happy. Thousands and thousands of people enjoy good Italian films, but also good international films. And we are ending on Saturday. But after that, we are opening another initiative on July 21st with an open air theater with different programming for 2 weeks at Ontario Place, Trillium Park.
So I know that you mentioned the pandemic and things being locked down and this bringing people together. What has it been like to plan a film festival in the midst of a pandemic?
It's a very, very, I have to say that it was very challenging. Mm-hmm. Working, you know, from home most time with the staff at home. But there was a lot of energy because there was the desire and the push for our audience, from the people, from our community, that really wanted to do something like this. So we received a lot of help from the community, from the sponsors, of course, even from the government that pushed us a lot, and we succeeded to organize something like this.
Which film are you looking most forward to watching during this film festival?
I am the artistic director, so
it's hard to say.
Choose all the movies. So these are the best movie for me. Imagine, I already gave you a selection of everything that is around, and I selected these 30 movies.
Now, during the film selection for this festival, was there any common themes? I know these films are from all over the world. Was there anything particular that you were looking for?
Yes, this year we decided to choose movie based on the fact that we were, after months of, again, lockdown, pandemic, bad news, we decided to have a Fil Rouge that was movies that they had to be uplifting. Not only comedies, but also drama and so on. But at the very end, we were thinking to the audience that this audience has to go out of the movie theater with a sense of hope and with some of relief. So the movies, most of them, actually the majority for sure, are movies that are uplifting movies.
Why did the ICFF opt to do a drive-in?
So why we decided to drive in? That was the only way at the very end to have an in-person festival. The theaters at that point when we started were closed. And having a virtual festival, an online festival, you can deliver the movies at home to your audience. But a festival is not just watching a movie. A festival is everything that's the packaging of that, the fact that you are together with other people, that you are commenting the movie, that you are speaking about the movie to other people, with the filmmakers, with the actors. So that was possible only with an in-person festival. An in-person festival was only possible through a drive-in, because the drive-in, of course, you are isolated in your bubble in your car, and you can avoid, of course, any problem related to gatherings in this COVID period.
Now, based on what you're saying, I know that you had a red carpet that you mentioned about. How did the red carpet really take place if everyone's in their car and everyone's staying in their bubble?
Exactly. This was one of the invention of this event. So we were, the question was how we can actually recreate the glamour of a red carpet of a festival, since we cannot have the paparazzi all together with the star there, because you know, we cannot separate them to you know, 10 feet apart. So we came up with this idea, say, you know, why we don't make the red carpet larger and have the cars going through the red carpet. So the artist, the filmmakers, the director, he stay in his car and connect with the host through Zoom with the phone. So in some way, we still have a red carpet, still we have a photographer. Instead of people and VIP coming through the red carpet with a beautiful clothes or beautiful dress, they come with beautiful cars. You look at the cars instead of the dress.
Is it almost like a bit of a parade when they're coming in? Like everyone sees their car coming in?
There is a sort of a lineup, a very beautiful lineup of beautiful cars.
On July 14th, on the same day as the National Day of France, Bastille Day, the ICFF showed the French film Bye Bye Morons. If this was intentional, why is it important for you and the other ICFF organizers to feature French films and movies on this day?
That was more than intentional. We really want it. That was the purpose, to celebrate every culture, every nation. And as we did for the 4th of July with the American consulate in Toronto, and we decided to do it together with the French consulate, an incredible event celebrating France, celebrating the French language, the French cinema. Imagine that. We couldn't do a French festival without France, since they invented cinema. So we wanted to celebrate this community, this large community of French speaking in Canada with an incredible movie. And again, it was a beautiful, beautiful experience. The festival is all about this. It's celebrating the multiculturalism, and France, of course, is an important part of this country.
Why did you and the other organizers or founders decide to display non-Italian international films during the Lavazza Drive-In Film Festival?
So we decided last year to have an international film festival beside the Italian film festival. So we opened a new festival that was international. The reason was because we understood that we could actually have a film festival in Toronto using the drive-in formula. And this could be, at that time, was the only way to have a social event in Toronto, because the drive-in, with the fact that the people were in the cars, created a way to barriers for the COVID. And so we were saying, why we don't do a festival that help all the other communities to again reunite themselves, having an event that can actually reinforce the sense of community? Because the lockdown, what happened with the lockdown? The lockdown really hurt the sense of community. Staying apart, staying at home, is the opposite of the sense of community, that staying together. So with the Lavazza Drive-In Film Festival last year that we opened, we were thinking we had to use this festival to make all these communities that are part of the mosaic of Toronto and Ontario to again start to see each other, enjoy something together, have a social moment. And so we wanted to really celebrate this period with a multicultural festival.
What is the direction you would like to go with the ICFF for the future and future film festivals? Would you try to do this again, have the drive-in aspects, or are you more set on just going back to a theater?
I always think that the best way to watch a movie is in the theater, because you still have the best quality of the picture, you have the best sound, you still have the emotions to share with other people in the theater. So for sure we are going to go back to the theaters. This experience was an incredible experience, to have a drive-in film festival, and in particular have a festival outside of the theater, open air, during the summer. So I have a feeling that I would like to keep part of this experience for the next editions. So probably we are going to do some, make some special events that are going to be drive-ins or open air next year.
I feel like this has opened up a whole new chapter for the ICFF of trying different things and trying some new things. Another question I have for you is, you have some special guests. I know that you mentioned on the red carpet, there's people coming in, and you have the Consul General tonight of France. Who are some of these special guests that you have coming in?
So we had another challenge for our festival. We are doing an international film festival with the problematic of not have the possibility to invite people from abroad because of course the quarantine and so on. So of course we celebrate a lot the Canadian artists, filmmakers, actors during this festival because they were local and they could come. Beside that, we celebrate the communities with all the leaders of these communities, from, of course, the Consul General of different countries, but also to community leaders. And we had film critics, journalists, influencers, and everybody that we couldn't have in person at the drive-in, we had it with this invention that we had 2 years ago of Zoom. So with Zoom, we connected the drive-in to the world. So we had filmmakers live from Japan, from Korea, from Russia, and of course from Europe, from South America, and so on. So this was the way to communicate live with them.
Do you feel like the turnout's even better now that you're inviting people via Skype and via video chat?
Of course, this is a way to save some money for sure, because you don't have to pay for the travel and the accommodation, but still to have an actor, filmmaker or director in person is another experience, because the live feed with the Zoom is 3 minutes, 5 minutes, 7 minutes. If you invite your actor here, the people can really enjoy the actor, the director for a longer time, and how they can do a selfie with the actor, with whom, is it possible? So it's something that we cannot avoid. So it's going to be in person next year.
Yes, well, hopefully everything works out and we can come see you next year live and in person, and we can take lots of selfies. And thank you so much for joining us, Cristiano, and have a great film festival.
Julia, I can't wait to have you on the red carpet. They drive through red carpet, so prepare your car.
Thank you. And thank you all for joining us at home. This has been Julia, and you're watching Inbox with Julia Cosby. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and turn on the bell notifications to see our next episode.